trust myself, couldn't stop myself. I did it all, you can play on me. It's not my fault, it's not my fault, it's not my fault. Every day is the same, yeah, I just watch them go. As I scrape away through the impossible. Yeah, I played the game, but it was all for show. Trying to find my way, I nearly lost it though. Now I see the people, most have no faith. Where did the time go? Oh, watch me no face. They hit the ceiling, but my roof like space. I took my chances, so what? You won't blame it on me. It's not my fault, it's not my fault, it's not my fault. Blame it on me.
Hey, Ashley!
No, I don't drink. You know I don't drink.
You're my best friend!
You're a coward!
Yo, drink it, man! Drink it! Drink it! Drink it! Drink it!
A terrible accident, and unfortunately, someone died in that accident. And during our investigations, we determined that they came from this house after the pond. Did you have?
We did. We had some kids here, and they all stayed here, and I collected everybody's keys. And
why did you collect their keys?
I didn't want anyone to sneak in drinks and driving or anything like that.
Okay. Do you know if they were drinking here?
Yes, they were.
They were.
Mm-hmm.
And you allowed that?
Yep, because I felt that they were here, I had their keys, nobody was driving, and I figured that was the safest way to go, instead of having them out cruising around in the streets.
Unfortunately, that's not what happened. Someone apparently snuck out, they were able to get their keys. What's going to happen now is that the Department of Children and Family gets notified for neglect on behalf of your children, because you allow the alcohol and underage drinking. Your violation of the social host law. You will also receive a notice through parent court for reckless child endangerment. Okay.
I'm sorry, I wasn't aware.
It's unfortunate. We try to get the message out there to parents all the time that you can't allow kids to drink. A lot of parents think that it's okay to allow the kids to drink or party a little bit at the house because they're safe there or they're not going to leave, and I'd rather them be at my house so we can watch them rather than go out in the woods or in the bogs or wherever they are partying, and that's not the case. Okay, it's not okay. Okay, so you are going to receive a summons to the parent court. You'll get that within the next few weeks for those specific charges, okay? For providing alcohol to a minor.
I didn't buy any of the alcohol for the minors.
That's up to you to prove in court.
Okay.
Okay?
Yeah.
As well as reckless child endangerment.
Okay.
As well as violation of the social host law. Okay? If you have any questions, you can feel free to give me a call at the police station, and we'll go from there, okay?
Okay. Well, okay. I'm very sorry. Okay.
It's not my fault. It's not my fault. It's not my fault.
911, this line's recorded. What's your emergency?
There's been a car accident. When do you call?
Okay, where's the car accident then?
Franklin Street. You need to hurry up.
Okay, are there any injuries?
I think so. People are hurt.
Okay, help's on the way, okay?
Okay. Right. Tyler, right here.
Where's Riley? Where did he go?
Where's he going?
Where's he going?
Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Officer Frazier with the Hanson Police Department. Today we conducted an exercise of a mock crash. We do this for the juniors and seniors up at Whitman Hanson. We conduct this drill every 2 years. And we do this for not only for kids underage drinking and driving, but for distractive driving, for instance, texting and so forth.
Educating kids and teaching them responsible ways is a parent's responsibility. I mean, to be asked to do this is a privilege, and I really hope the kids get something out of it.
I think we were all overwhelmed by how many students came up to us during the assembly to thank us for participating and for asking, you know, questions and wanting more information. So I really do think that it makes a difference.
Hi, my name is Camp Carpenter.
I'm Jason Bannon.
I'm Riley McDonald.
I'm Ashley Memelo, and today we did a demonstration of how drunk driving can make really big impacts on everyone in the community. And this demonstration was not to scare anyone. It was really just to keep in the back of your mind that your decisions have profound impacts on everyone.
I think Ashley said that perfectly. We just really all want to stay safe. We all love each other so much, and we don't want to mess it up in the final year.
I think it's very surreal after, especially when we all walked back into the auditorium with all of our students, and they all were very like surprised, and they all wanted to hug us and make sure we were okay, and I think it's definitely eye-opening for everybody that it could happen to anybody.
I'd like to thank the Whitman Police Department, both Whitman and Hanson Fire Department, the Plymouth County Sheriff's Department, 14 and 58 Liquors for donating some props for the party scene. I'd also like to thank Macquarie Auto for donating the cars, as well as Hanson Express for coming today and documenting certain scenes. I'd really like to thank all the actors in the SAD program that took part in this. Special thank you to two of the parents that took part in this, Randy LaMattina and Darcy McDonald. They played the parents of the victims in this car accident, as well as Randy's daughter, Claire LaMattina. They were all amazing. The point of this is to teach the kids that there are consequences to your actions. If you are distracted when you're driving, whether it be underage drinking and driving or texting and driving, it could be severe. And in this situation, it was fatal. It caused someone to lose their life. And we teach the kids that not only is it affecting that person that unfortunately passed, but it affects their family and their friends and all their other loved ones. So I'm hoping the kids learned a valuable lesson today. And again, thank you. I appreciate it.